right, I'm Jason Whitlock. Ooh. He's Marcellus Wiley. That dude?
Yes, sir.
All right, Want to Speak for Yourself, the most fearless show in sports. Coming up, we'll tell you if Patrick Mahomes will be able to top his MVP numbers from last year. And in about 30 minutes, we'll tell you if Jay-Z will end up in the NFL before Colin Kaepernick does. Ooh. But we start today with the Cowboys. Dak Prescott is not disrespected, saying it would be a mistake for the Cowboys to pay Dak $30 million isn't disrespect. It's common sense. But stop the delusional Dak sanity. Former NFL quarterback Sean Salisbury is the latest talking head to get swept up in Dak sanity. Dak sanity is a CTE complication that causes football experts to argue that Dak deserves the kind of money earned by Russell Wilson, Aaron Rodgers, Carson Wentz, and Matt Ryan, simply because Dak was on the roster when the Cowboys won 30 regular season games over the last three seasons. Salisbury, now a radio host in Houston, appeared on the Dan Patrick radio show yesterday and proclaimed that Dak is the most underrated quarterback in the NFL and is extremely disrespected. The NFL Network's Bucky Brooks, someone I consider the smartest man in football, is the ringleader of Dak sanity. You heard him right here on this show spewing Dak delusion.
The problem that people have is, for whatever reason, Dak Prescott is not viewed as a franchise quarterback. But I challenge Cowboy fans. Do you remember Quincy Carter? Do you remember Chad Hutchinson? How about Drew Henson?
Why
did you like those days?
Fans, Bucky?
Because that's what the issue is.
That's the issue.
No. That's the issue.
That is. Bucky's not alone. Our man T.J. Houshmandzadeh is part of the Dak sanity movement, too.
Like, Dak Prescott got to be the most disrespected player in the league, bro. It's by everybody.
Stop it. Dak sanity is a different form of Kaepernicking. There's nothing we love to do more than give black quarterbacks bad advice. When Colin Kaepernick was burning up money in his NFL career with his Hey, Look at Me anthem protest, the media Kaepernick spent all year applauding his self-destructive publicity stunt slash temper tantrum. You ever see a media Kaepernick protest social injustice on their job? The media love to give black quarterbacks advice they wouldn't follow themselves. No one in the media, not Sean Salisbury, not Bucky Brooks, not my guy, that dude,
what?
Believes Dak Prescott is a top 10 NFL quarterback. So how is it disrespectful to say Dak doesn't deserve a contract that would pay him like he's a top 5 passer? It's not. It's common sense. Dak's sanity is going to destroy Dak Prescott. This kid had a hell of a brand, a hell of a reputation. Everyone liked Dak Prescott. He was an underdog story. Yesterday, a friend from Texas sent me an internet meme mocking Prescott. It showed a man smoking crack, and the caption read, "The moment before Dak asked for $40 million.
Pookie!
Every day of Dak's sanity is a bad day for Dak Prescott. The longer his contract dispute plays out publicly, the more damage is done to his brand in the minds of football fans and his Cowboys teammates. He looks greedy and delusional. The constant conversation about what Dak is really worth is poison inside the Cowboys locker room.
Boy.
Dak's teammates don't suffer from Dak's sanity. They have Dak envy. They're looking at a guy who is on the cusp of being paid much more than he's worth. A football locker room is no different from any workplace. Do you like and respect your highly overpaid coworker? You know who benefits from Dak's sanity? Dak's agent, Todd France. If France can get Prescott overpaid, it enhances France's brand as a negotiator. He can go recruit future clients with the narrative, "I'm the agent who got the Cowboys to pay Dak Prescott $30 million. That's the greatest recruiting pitch since the University of Louisville basketball program opened a strip club inside his dormitories.
Hey.
If Dak were a free agent this offseason, he would have commanded a similar contract as Nick Foles, who signed for an average of $22 million a year. Dak disrespect is a myth. Dak delusion is reality. All right, joining the desk now are Fox Sports NFL analyst Eric Mangini, Fox Sports college football analyst and NFL legend Reggie Bush. Marcellus, I'll start with you.
Yeah.
Think Dak is disrespected?
Absolutely, he's being disrespected.
Oh, here we go.
He didn't throw me in the video with the montage. I started this. Respect to Dak Prescott, who is trying to control what he can't control when you're on the football field. And most of that is materialized through numbers. And the ultimate number is, did you win? We all know, since he's been in the league, second most wins at the position, okay?
Regular season.
Do you? Oh, there. You.
I'm just throwing.
I have information. And listening to your
window. We know.
Yeah.
I know you got that information.
I do like and respect coworkers who are overpaid, right? That's how I do.
You're my boy. You're my dog. Nah, you work. I'll give you that. You do grind.
That said, this is all about comps. When you go to the housing market, you go to any sector where comps change value and change price. Dak Prescott, and you're talking about the numbers, man. If you look at the top 10 quarterbacks by salary, do you know that six of them didn't even make the playoffs last year? Six of them. And then there's a seventh in Carson Wentz where you're like, your team did, but did you? Because you never play in those games. So with that said, Todd France has comps. And he's like, I'm going to focus in on these comps, and I'm certainly going to narrow down to the Carson Wentz number, and that's where we're stuck at. He's being disrespected because his numbers are what he can control. His numbers have surpassed people in his top 10, and he's not getting paid accordingly.
Marcellus, I've been to your house. Mm-hmm. If we moved it to your old neighborhood in Compton, the value would go down.
It would.
Dak ain't in the same neighborhood as these other quarterbacks he's trying to get paid like. Go. Somebody help me out. He's not being disrespected.
No, I don't think he's being disrespected. And I don't think this is a function of respect or disrespect. It's just business. Mm-hmm. And in this business, especially when we look at the NFL free agency, guys are constantly signed for values that they don't deserve because it's free agency, and that's what the market bears. This is what the market bears right now, and the fact that Carson Wentz signed where he signed, that is a very fair comparable for his agent and for Dak to work off of. He's got more wins. He's got more head-to-head wins. He's got more conference wins. He's got playoff wins. He has a better completion percentage. They came in the same year. Why shouldn't he get at least the number that Carson Wentz got? And this isn't about respect or not respect. It's about the market and comparables.
Yeah, I think Coach just hit it on the head. I don't think he's being disrespected. I think some of his inconsistencies throughout the season may warrant some of the criticism that he gets. But you're the quarterback of America's team. You're the quarterback of the Dallas Cowboys, which is one of the richest franchises in all of sports. And so you're going to get criticism that comes along with that. And he took over for Tony Romo, right? And so the way he took over for Tony Romo, people were expecting him to be as good or better. There has been some up and down games, but I don't think he's disrespecting. And I also agree with you as well. He's the next man up. And that's kind of where the quarterback market is. It's not even about the numbers as much anymore.
When you start talking about Derek Carr, or did you mention Joe Flacco, Nick Foles?
I ain't going down there.
Those are the neighborhoods he belongs in. But let's quit acting like, because some of us are saying, hey, man, you're good, but I wouldn't pay you $30 million. That's not disrespect. Mm-hmm. That's an evaluation of the market. And again, that's people go in and put a bid on a house. Sometimes they come in low. Mm-hmm. Someone else, a sucker, may come in high and overpay for Dak like you would. I'm going to buy Dak at the house price that he's worth. 23, 24, 25.
No, you're not. No, you're not. Your house is going to be sitting there. Whitlock will be in there chilling. Do you know why? Carson Wentz, is he the fourth best quarterback in our league? Why is he getting paid like it? Is Kirk Cousins the sixth best quarterback in our league? Why is he getting paid like it? Jimmy G, the seventh best quarterback in our league? And these are people that I actually respect. But are they even close to what they're getting paid in compensation in terms of ranking in the league? No. So why now, all of a sudden, that's the strongest argument we have against Dak when we don't have that same argument against everyone else?
If Dak Prescott was a free agent, he would get more than $32 million.
Oh, stop, no.
If Dak Prescott was out in the open market, he would get more than $32 million.
Name a team.
Look, we look at this all the time, and you saw the Minnesota Vikings come in at how much guaranteed money for
84.
Kirk Cousins?
Mm-hmm.
Like, and nobody necessarily thought that was going to be the number they came in at.
Right.
When you are a free agent and there's 32 teams and most of them are desperate for a quality quarterback,
you're
going to overpay. That's the way it is. And you're not just betting on, or you're not just saying, this is what I'm paying you for what you did. You're betting on the come. You're betting on the future. What do you think this player can be?
And why would he get more than Nick Foles? Just this past offseason, why would he get more than Nick?
Because he doesn't have the failures in his resume that Nick Foles has.
Or the successes.
You know, that's true, but hold on. In spot duty. True. Come on. Nick Foles didn't take that from beginning to end.
Right.
That's a spliced situation there between Carson Wentz carrying the water and then Nick Foles saving the day. But at the end of the day, you still have a body of resume against Nick Foles that you don't have in the negative towards
him. And that is the upside of not having that much tape, is you have the ability, right, if you're an organization that wants to sign a guy, to say, we think he's going to be this, where a guy like Nick Foles has a much bigger body of work, and you don't know which guy you're necessarily going
to
get.
Right.
Yeah, I know we love to use the Carson Wentz comparison, but are we willing to sit here and say that when you turn on the film, you look at Carson Wentz, and you look at Dak Prescott, that there is not a clear-cut difference in his ability to be accurate, push the football down the field, win games, all those different things?
I'm sorry, Reggie, I haven't been in your house. I know it's immaculate, it's huge, expansive. When you turn on that film in your house, it's not Carson Wentz on that film a lot of times because he's on the sideline.
For the playoffs.
He's never won a playoff game. He's only won two meaningful December games, and one of them he couldn't even finish.
He was in the MVP conversation.
Get him.
So was
he in the MVP conversation? Ready for this
was he in the MVP conversation? So has Dak ever been in the MVP conversation?
No, but has Derek Carr? Yeah, he was in the MVP conversation until he got hurt. And nobody's sitting here going, Derek Carr should be making $34 million a year.
Right.
Just because someone's in the conversation for a little while doesn't mean they necessarily need to be in the conversation long term.
I'm going
to
stick with the housing analogies. I'm not going to go sexist.
Are we in Compton or are we in the valley where I'm at?
Well, we're talking about amenities inside the house.
Okay.
Carson Wentz has a pool in the backyard. Uh-huh. Dak doesn't. That's why his price is so high. It's the talent. Was he the number two pick in the draft?
Yeah.
The evaluators have already said early on what neighborhood Carson Wentz was in.
Yeah.
Dak is trying to be the Beverly Hillbillies and move on to a new neighborhood, George Jefferson and move on up to a new neighborhood. But there's a lot of the homeowners association is saying you're not qualified.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You don't have the right amenities.
Yeah.
You don't have a Super Bowl, you don't have the talent, you don't have a pool in your backyard, you're not fit for this neighborhood.
When you buy a house, you have an inspector go look at it, and Carson Wentz's pool might not work. You know, and there's a lot of things.
How the pool not gonna work? You can put some water in it.
It just don't work. The filter, all that,
right, everything ain't working.
And you're playing with the numbers here. In football, there's always an equation when you're talking about value. You can highlight the strengths, or you can highlight the weaknesses. And if you believe there's upside, you start to highlight the strengths.
Yeah.
Like you said, Dak has intangibles that need to be highlighted on top of numbers that shouldn't be cooked. And right now, a lot of people are cooking the books on Dak because they don't like everything that they see. But it doesn't matter. Maybe your eyes are deceiving you.
Holding on to the football too long.
All right, the sacks got it. Russell Wilson has sack issues as well.
Don't compare him to Russell.
I'm just saying the sack problem. Okay.
Carson Wentz got hit at a rate that was higher than any quarterback early in the season.
And took his toll.
Because he wouldn't release the ball.
Yeah.
That's one of his biggest issues. Is he needs to learn how to get rid of the football.
Yeah.
Listen, no one up here understands the business of football. Well, all three of you understand the business of football at a very high level. When you get drafted that high, it impacts your second contract.
It bleeds. Yeah.
No question about it. That happens all the time.
Yeah.
And so that's what's happened to Carson Wentz. Look, I hate to be in this position where it sounds like I can't stand Dak Prescott. Because it's just not true.
Mm-hmm.
I just think the guy right now is a 25 and on the high end, a $27 million quarterback.
Mm-hmm.
Right now.
Mm.
Maybe he can prove to be something else. That's not disrespect.
That's not disrespect. Yeah,
Stick with him, but not at some ridiculous price that I'm telling you, and I keep going back to it, his teammates. If he comes in at $30 million or above, his teammates are going to turn on him.
And I didn't mean to interrupt, but when we talk about respect and disrespect, you've got Tom Brady making $23 million. Mm-hmm. If you want to go to the disrespect world, that's like